At number 10, Tyson Fury knocks down Deontay Wilder to retain titles. WBC and lineal heavyweight champion Tyson Fury beat Deontay Wilder for the third time and final time on Saturday, October 9, in a very entertaining heavyweight clash in Las Vegas. Fury delivered a full blow in the 11th round to end Wilder's defiant display. But the Gypsy King, still undefeated in his career, rallied and then sent Wilder into a continuous barrage of onslaughts in the next round. After giving Wilder a knockdown in the 10th round, Fury sealed the victory in the 11th round with a devastating punch that sent his American rival crashing to the floor. This is the third time both fighters faced each other. The first fight ended as a draw, which many thought Fury won, and the second was a win by Fury, and now this is the third. At number 9, Pretty Mike shares his opinion about marriage. Socialite Pretty Mike is of the opinion that marriage is a high achievement and an accomplishment. He stated this in a post he shared on his Instagram page. He wrote, and I quote, "Don't allow anybody trick you by telling you that marriage is not an achievement. Marriage is a high achievement, an accomplishment, and a beautiful union. To see two people or more come together and build an awesome home and family together." At number 8, Two Faces Management releases a statement following Brymo's allegation. Two Faces Management, now Music, has released a statement following singer Brymo's reaction to being served court papers over the allegation he leveled against the veteran singer. Recall that Two Faces have threatened to file a 1 billion naira defamation lawsuit against his colleague Brymo if he fails to apologize over claims of Two Faces accusing him of sleeping with his wife and arranging for him to be assaulted. Reacting to this, Two Faces Management stated, "It is up to fans to decide if the veteran singer's reign is over or if it is Brymo's turn to ascend the throne." They stressed that Brymo will have an opportunity to substantiate his claims with proof in court, as Two Faces won't be dissipating any energy engaging him in media exchanges. At number 7, Akuapem Polo vehemently thanks Cardi B. Rosemond Alade Brown, aka Akuapem Polo, couldn't contain her excitement after discovering that Cardi B posted her on her Instagram stories. Akuapem calls herself Cardi B's twin and even went viral when she showed Cardi B her twerking skills when the American rapper visited Ghana. Recently, Akuapem chose to channel Cardi by recreating the rapper's iconic look for a magazine shoot. Cardi saw Akuapem's version and shared side-by-side photos of her and Akuapem on her Instagram stories. She then tagged Akuapem. When the Ghanaian actress saw that Cardi B posted her, she did a video expressing her excitement. At number 6, Fred Amata celebrates his sister, who got married at the age of 60. Filmmaker Fred Amata has took to Instagram to celebrate his sister, who was getting married for the first time at the age of 60, noting that his sister grew up in a strict environment and eventually became an example of steadfastness and commitment. Amata revealed that his sister was ridiculed after she approached 40 unmarried. However, in spite of being ridiculed, the filmmaker said his sister persevered. Amata disclosed that his sister was getting married on October 9th at the age of 60 after they had all given up hope. At number 5, Lagos Police warns against hashtag NSAS anniversary protest. The Lagos State Police Command has warned residents of the state against staging any protest to commemorate the one-year anniversary of the hashtag NSAS protest in the state. Last October, youths across Nigeria took to the streets to demand an end to police brutality. The protest took a violent turn after it was hijacked by thugs. In a statement released by its spokesperson, CSP Adekunle Ajisebutu, the state police command says credible intelligence at its disposal indicates that some youths, individuals, or groups were planning to embark on a protest in commemoration of one-year anniversary of NSAS. The command says Lagosians and indeed Nigerians cannot afford to relive the distasteful experience of last year's protest, which caused pain, anguish, needless loss of lives, and wanton destruction of public and private property. The command warned against individuals or groups who may want to stage an anniversary protest to jettison the idea now or face the full weight of the law. At number 4, Facebook proposes feature to nudge teens away from harmful content. Facebook will be introducing several features, including prompting teens to take a break from using its photo sharing app Instagram and nudging teens if they are repeatedly looking at the same content that's not conducive to their well-being. The Facebook executive said that the company will introduce new measures on its apps to prompt teens away from harmful content as US lawmakers scrutinize how Facebook and subsidiaries like Instagram affect young people's mental health. Facebook also expressed openness to the idea of letting regulators have access to Facebook algorithms that are used to amplify content. At number 3, 2022 World Cup will be my last, Neymar reveals. Paris Saint-Germain and Brazil forward Neymar has said that the 2022 World Cup will be his last as he doesn't have the strength to put up with more football. The enigmatic striker said he might not be emotionally capable of playing in 2026, so he will give his all in the next World Cup so Brazil can win it. Neymar, who has played in 2 World Cups and is his country's second top scorer of all time behind Pele, will be 34 when the 2026 tournament rolls around. "I think 2022 will be my last World Cup," the 29-year-old said. "I will play it like it's my last because I don't know if I will still have the mental strength to put up with even more football." End of quote. at number 2. My last relationship was disastrous, says Mercy Ake. Reality TV star Mercy Ake has taken to social media to talk about her last relationship, which was with co-reality show star Ike Onyema. Mercy Ake, in a video she said her last relationship was a disaster. This is coming after Ike opened up on why their relationship crashed. He stated that his relationship with Mercy Ake wasn't it because many people had an opinion. Ike also revealed that he would like to date a lady that is intelligent, pretty much independent, and not so freaked about social media.
I mean, my last relationship, it was a total disaster.
At number 1. Toto DK shares cryptic photo online. Nollywood actress Toto DK has taken to her Instagram page to share a photo of herself wearing a shirt with an inscription that reads, "This one, she no fit stay man house." Toto DK shared the photo while participating in a challenge started by singer Simi on the negativity thrown at women. Others who have participated include Adetuo Aitomi, Temi Otedola, Osasi Godalo, and others. And that's it, our daily top 10. For more entertainment stories, follow us on all social media platforms, Nigezi Extreme on Instagram and Nigezi TV on Facebook. YouTube channel is Nigezi TV. Hit the subscribe button and smash a like on this video.